Welcome to the special Nerdactyl podcast on the PlayStation 5 reveal event wishlist. I'm your host, Scott, and on the show today, we've got Ollie.
Hey.
This show is brought to you by quarantine, the coronavirus. As you can see, we're not in the studio. Well, this has kind of become the studio for the last 6 weeks now, something like that.
Yeah, my bedroom is my studio.
It feels like 6 months, maybe 6 years. I don't know. I mean, feels like
it's been a long time.
Last time I got my haircut was about 6 years ago. It feels like it's getting bad. It really is getting bad.
I mean, we've kind of held off. Like most people I know have shaved their head, but I feel like we've done quite well not to do that.
Yeah, I don't think I could do that. I don't think I could. I don't think I could pull off a shaved head, to be honest. I'm not at that level yet. I'm bad, but I'm not at that level. Also, can't drink alcohol for this because it seems like today the pollen count is just gone off the roof. Like I went from yesterday not sneezing at all to today sneezing fits every 2 seconds, and apparently booze makes me worse. So we're doing this one sober. It's unusual. It's very unusual. So they are doing the PlayStation 5 gaming reveal event. Don't know what that means. It's been very vague so far. Don't know if that means we're going to see the console, if we're going to see anything else like VR, or you know, if it's just going to be literally videos of games. Don't know if it's going to be like a conference even. Could be anything. So we decided to make a little wish list of 5 games that we would like to see each, and also a wild card of this, just any dream game that probably won't happen, but would be awesome. So the running order is we're going to quickly talk about the rumors so far, and then we're going to go through our 5 games each. Go through a wild card, and then we should put out a shout out to the, or we put out a question to the community to see what they thought and what they wanted. And we've got a few comments that we'll read out at the very end. So, rumored so far, and well, confirmed games already. Things like we're getting a new FIFA, we're getting Call of Duty, could be getting a new Batman game, Assassin's Creed Valhalla, Godfall, Watch Dogs Legion could be PlayStation 5. Gods and Monsters, Cyberpunk, all things that are to be expected, really, you know?
Yeah.
And to be honest, I see this gaming event to be pretty much just seeing, you know, next-gen Call of Duty, next-gen FIFA, nothing. I don't really see many shocks or surprises.
Just update the graphics and maybe update the gameplay?
Yeah, I mean, how much has Call of Duty really changed over the last, you know, 40 years.
Well, FIFA has drastically changed, but I think it's changed for the worse. That's probably really controversial, but it's just, I know. Like, yeah. FIFA years ago was so much fun, and now it's so stressful.
It's almost like the more they try and make things realistic, the more things are just scripted, and, you know.
Yeah.
So, to be honest, I don't really think we're going to get many surprises in this this gaming event reveal, whatever it is. I think we're just going to see prettier versions of games we already know about, but let's go on to what we would like to see. So we'll do this. I'll go with one of mine, one of yours, one of mine, one of yours. Because we might have some.
What if you say one and the one I'm going to say is the exact same? Is that okay? We'll just talk about why we.
I mean, it does go against the rules of the podcast, and you know that these rules are set in stone, like that blood contract that we signed. But we'll get around it. We'll see what happens. So I've kind of went for a bit of a mix of some old, some new, and some sort of different, okay? So first up, VR. VR came along kind of late into PS4, and it felt like a bit of just an add-on, and never really felt like it was being taken fully seriously, whereas I think if you come out of the gates and say, look, games are going to be playable in VR, we've got some AAA games, and there's a VR bundle announced at the very start, and you introduce VR at the start of a life cycle, I think that's going to make it taken more seriously, you know? So I think
definitely, yeah.
Now is the time for Gran Turismo. I think Gran Turismo 6 or 7, or I actually don't even know what number it's on, but I know we didn't
I think 7 will be the new one.
Seven?
Yeah.
Because we know it's coming. We know they've had plenty of time to work on it. So I think come out of the gates, Gran Turismo, and it looks photorealistic, you know? That's a good way to show off PS5's engine. And then hit at the very end, say, and the whole game's playable in VR. I think that's a good way to start.
Definitely. That actually links in quite well with my first recommendation or like a wish list game.
Okay.
That you could use VR for. So it took a while to think about my five different ones. Now, some of them are sequels to games that came out for PS4, but yeah. I can't help that. Naturally, I want to see like, progression of a story.
Of course.
But then I thought about what remake would I really want for a game that came out for the PS1 years ago.
Great, great.
So I was thinking Silent Hill. It's been rumoured.
Yes.
And a remake that you can do VR and that would be, well, terrifying and awesome, I think. Updated graphics, updated gameplay. You could do first person or over the shoulder, like the way the RE engine has done, the Resident Evil engine. I think that would be great, to be honest. I think that would be so popular. Remake.
That would be...
Graphics nowadays, too. I mean, there's so much you can do.
That makes total sense. I think, I think that's a no-brainer for them to bring back Silent Hill, especially because Konami don't really know what they're doing at the moment. And that would be a nice, solid, easy remaster for them, or remake, sorry. So, good shout. Kind of leads me into my next one, which is... So, like I said, I want the mix of some old, some established IP, and maybe some remakes and something new. I think they could drum up a lot of hype for the new console by giving us a new IP, something fresh, never seen before. Who better to do it than Kojima? So you've had Death Stranding, that's been out for a wee bit of time now. So I think if you come out the gates with a Kojima new IP, completely bizarre, but it's only on PlayStation, you're going to drum up a lot of hype, you know?
Oh yeah, 100%.
So I think that could be an exciting one. I don't know what the IP is. Maybe something in space. I think space could be the next big theme, you know? So
yeah, definitely.
There you go. Like some kind of Kojima IP. I don't know what. So
nice.
On to yourself.
This one's obvious, and I feel like a lot of people want this, but I'm going to say GTA 6. But have it. I was thinking about what way could it, I mean, they could do go back in the past. I mean, they did the 80s with Vice City, but I'd like to see a GTA 6, or at least a gameplay format that takes you back to like the 70s. Something we haven't really seen before. I feel like that would be quite cool. Another way you could probably use VR for it, or the story mode.
Totally. Man, VR GTA, like, that's going to appeal to the psychopaths out there.
I feel like GTA is going to be one they're going to bring out anyway. I don't know if they'll announce that next week. I feel it's been sort of shrouded in a lot of secrecy. Nothing's really been released that I know of, like plot details, characters and stuff.
No, nothing. Agreed. Actually, GTA 6 is next on my list. I think it's time. Like, you didn't have a GTA game. You had a remaster or a remake, or not a remake. You had a port of GTA 5, but you haven't actually had a new GTA game since the PS3, Xbox 360 era. So now's the time. And I think if you come out with a GTA game, the biggest selling thing ever, and you show it in PS5, like, that's going to drum excitement up, you know, tenfold. So GTA was my next one as well. So
I think, well, while we're on that, before we go on to the next one, I enjoyed GTA 5. I enjoyed, well, the graphics, the gameplay, the story. It was cool getting to be three different characters, but I feel like for GTA 6, I should go back to just having the one main protagonist, I think.
Yeah, I think so. I think that kind of distracted me a wee bit as well. I don't know. It's nice just concentrating on one person, but no, you're right. Definitely GTA 6. So on to your next one, I think.
I'm going to say a sequel to Spider-Man 2. Spider-Man, sorry.
Oh,
PS4 one. Or a Spider-Verse game.
You want to see Spidey of some form? I think Spider-Man 2's all but... I think it is confirmed that's happening. So you would want to see it this early, aye?
Oh, definitely, yeah. I mean, what was 2 years since the first one came out? But even at that, I mean, I got through the story in like 2 days. So a Spider-Man 2 game that with a longer story would be up there on my wish list, to be honest.
Absolutely. So I had Spider-Man 2 on my list and I changed it at the last minute because I want to see Spider-Man 2. Like, it needs to come out. It's Spider-Man 2, or Spider-Man 1 was one of my favorite games for last generation. But... So I was thinking, obviously, we only had 5 slots. If I had 6, Spidey would have been on it. But in terms of games coming back, you know, you've got your big games of the last generation, God of War, Horizon, Spidey, Uncharted, all that kind of stuff. I was like, I don't want to pick too many of them because you got to space it out. You know, if you announce all of them at once, then there's no hype. Like, they might only come out one a year. And then you've no hype. So I thought, well, I'm only gonna pick one for the reveal event. And I went with Horizon because it was just such a breakout IP from the PS4 era. And you want to establish that now as the new PlayStation sort of top tier brand, basically. And not only that, the gameplay was just so original in it. I think there's so much that they could do to show off new gameplay mechanics. Like, you might be able to lay advanced traps, maybe fight tons, hordes of dinosaurs at once, but I think you could really use Horizon 2 to show off the tech of PS5, and it'll be something original. Yeah. And yeah, that's why I went with Horizon 2. But I was so close to Spidey and God of War, but I think there's time for them. But Horizon 1, I think, is the oldest out of the three of those. So
yeah, I think it is, yeah.
Let's go Horizon first, and then, you know, next E3 or whatever.
Yeah, Spider-Man, my Spider-Man choice is, like, you know, coming off, like, the newest of my choice, if that makes sense. Like, Spider-Man only came out, like, 2 years ago.
Yeah.
The other ones have picked their games that haven't been done, or sequels of games years ago.
Yeah.
But I feel like it's okay.
Of course. No, that makes sense. I was so tempted to have my cake and eat it and have just God of War, Spider-Man, Uncharted, you know.
I mean, I thought you loved Spider-Man. I thought you'd have Spider-Man in there.
I do, but, you know, only got five choices, and I want to give a bit of a mix. So, yes, your next one?
My next one would probably be a new Batman game, to be honest.
Okay, cool.
I know there was one rumored. It was a Court of Owls, I think.
Basically,
I think it would allow you to play as all members of, like, the Batman family. You could be, like, Robin, Nightwing, Batgirl. Yes. I think that's something would be great, to be honest. And something like an online multiplayer on that, I think, would be so cool, to be honest.
Would be
getting
great
to play
with
friends. I mean, like, you could be Batman, I could be Nightwing, someone else could be, Chris could be Batgirl, like, something else. Like,
yeah.
I think it'd be really cool, to be honest, and something else in there.
And you're right, like, if they did introduce, like, an online, that would be a new element. You know, something new and original to show off for the PS5. Yeah. That'll be good choice. Okay, good choice. So my last one, it's time, god damn it, it's time for a new Crash Bandicoot game. It is time. They've tested it with the Insane Trilogy, the remaster. There's a demand. People want bloody Crash games. I want a Crash game. No more remasters, make a new game. It's been, I don't know, PS2 generation since we had the last, like, side-on platformer. And give us what we want. It's time. That's all I can say. So yeah, that's what I just want to see, a classic platformer. You know, nothing. Don't want to see them reinvent the wheel and give us, like, a, you know, an RPG or anything like they've tried to do. I just want a classic Crash game, but a new one. So
yeah,
there you go.
That would be awesome. To be honest, that'd be so cool.
Number five for you.
This is really hard. And, like, I don't know if this is something they'll do. I mean, it's sort of like a remake, but I would love to see. Yeah, I was a big fan of the Lord of the Rings games for the PS2 years ago when they came out. I'd love to see something like that.
Yes.
Not necessarily that same story, that same sort of gameplay, to be honest. Like, something Lord of the Rings based, I think.
Well, there's that weird-looking Gollum game coming. I think that's confirmed.
Yeah,
for
I'm not counting that because I just don't know if it's for me.
Yeah, that's probably the closest, I imagine, but it would be awesome if they did come out and announce, like, a new proper Lord of the Rings game, maybe even an online RPG or something would be.
Yeah, like an open world game, even.
Yeah, oh, that'd be awesome.
Would be great.
So that's our five picks. I've got a wild card here. Do you have a wild card as well?
I do, yeah. Okay. Which will never happen.
Yeah, same. This will never happen either, but I fucking love it. So my wild card, open world Arkham City, right? Except it's the Ninja Turtles. And you're going about New York City, and you can swap between the four of them, and you go through the sewers, and you go on top, and you're, you know.
Damn, that sounds really good.
Make it an online thing if you want, but either way, just a proper open world Ninja Turtles game that's kind of dark, but kind of funny, like dark humor, you know, not too babyish, not too bright and colorful like the cartoons, but also not Michael Bay. So somewhere in between. And yeah. I don't care what studio makes it, just why not? So there you go. What about yourself?
I don't know if you'll agree with me. I mean, this is a DC character, which I don't think we've had much of in video games. I could be wrong. I know there is Injustice, Gods Among Us, but
yeah.
I would love to see, like, an open world or even the style of, like, the Spider-Man game for Superman. Make it, like, a really good Superman game.
Yeah.
Because that's something you could do in VR as well.
Well, there's actually Superman 64. For the Nintendo 64, do you remember that? You ever see that? No.
Oh yes, that's right. Yeah. Oh, they could remake that.
Flying through the rings. I think it was at one point the worst reviewed game of all time. or something.
Just one remake and make it really good, obviously.
Oh, perfect. Superman 64 remake. I love it. No, but seriously, I think that'd be class. I would love to see a proper Superman game. Maybe it's just tricky to make a game about an invincible character. I've no idea. Yeah. But that would be class if we could figure it out.
I mean, there's might be ways around it. Have kryptonite in and make it like a real like sort of threat. Yeah. In it, you know, ways you have to work around it, I think would be quite cool.
Did you say open world?
Yeah.
It'd be cool if you could like fly up to other planets and all as well.
Could they? Or just fly around Metropolis or different cities. Yeah, go back to Smallville.
Make the world. Show off PS5. Make the world. You can just fly around the world. Why not?
I'm just going to go to Brazil here and save this family.
So it's a Superman No Man's Sky crossover and you can fly different planets.
With unlockable costumes. I want to see that black Superman costume.
Yeah. That's a nice one. I never thought about a Superman sort of open world thing. There you go. So we put the question out on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, all that stuff, and we got a couple of suggestions from the community. Okay. So Joel says a Jackie Chan Stuntmaster remake. Did you ever play the Jackie Chan game?
No, I didn't even realize there was one.
Oh man, oh, it's something to behold. PS1, absolutely brilliant. I only played it once or twice, but I've seen YouTube videos of it, and it's why not a Jackie Chan Stuntmaster game? Hell, I would play that. Lewis says a Pepsi Man game. Pepsi Man being it's literally what you think. A PS1 game, and it was the Pepsi mascot, and you played as him. It was like an endless runner, like a temple runner type thing. Just why not? That would show off the power of PS5 if we had an endless runner, you know. Why not? Dave has a couple of suggestions saying a Metal Gear Solid 1 remake would be pretty tight.
Oh yeah, definitely.
That's a good shout.
That was a good shout.
That's something I can see them doing eventually. Whether they put it in a PS5 reveal or not, not sure. I'm not sure it's something that you would, you know, front load your console with. Well, I suppose maybe you could, but I can see that happening at some point. And Dave says more Uncharted. Now, Ollie hasn't played through Uncharted 4 yet, so I'm treading lightly here. I don't want to say too much. I think there is going to be more Uncharted. I don't think Naughty Dog's going to do it. And I'm okay with that. I have to be very careful what I say here.
I'll leave the room. You can talk. I'll come
no,
back.
It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. So I can see it happening. I think it will happen, but
I'm working my way through them. I just need to play the fourth one and then we're all good.
I want to see it at some point. I'm not sure I'm ready for more Uncharted yet, but I want to see it at some point. Uncharted 4 is just such a great end to the story. I'm really, really dreading softly here. It's a good end when it's time for a break. So anyway, that was our wish list. Whether any of that happens, I'm sure we'll just get an hour of Call of Duty, FIFA, you know, NBA, all that kind of stuff. Yeah. We'll do a reaction to it as well. And hopefully some of our wishes came true. So please do drop a follow or like or whatever the hell it is on YouTube. Follow, like,
subscribe.
Oh my god, how did I forget that? drop us a subscribe. Please subscribe to the channel. Give us a thumbs up. That would be awesome. And find us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that crap. Thanks very much. I've been Scott, and this has been Ollie.
Thanks.
Cheers.
Bye-bye.